There's dirt on my hands. They seem gonna sleep this night. Try to catch me howling at the moon.
Welcome to Photo Vibrance. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started creating animated images inside of Vibrance. So you have two options. You can either drag and drop an image over here or click to browse from your desktop, or you can go through the stock image integrations and search for an image using Pexels or Pixabay. I'm going to go and grab an image from my desktop and just drop it in like so. Okay, cool. So now over here, what we can do is change the resolution. And you can set custom dimensions over here. If you select custom, you can go back to the original image size, or you can set, you know, sizes that are good for social media, like the square one over here. So I'm just gonna select that and click on next. Okay, great. So inside the editor, we've got options such as adding text. You can add your logo or an image. You can add effects, shapes. You can adjust the size again, and you can publish your project as well as save your project to work on it at a later stage. So what I'm going to do first of all is begin animating. So what you can do is just zoom into the image over here, and you want to go through and set some anchors where you don't want the image to move. So I'm going to go and grab single and just simply start clicking around here, and I just want to, you know, set the water in motion. So I want to kind of, you know, freeze everything around the water. Okay, great. You can also use the path option if you want to just simply click and then click and hit enter, and then it will basically add the paths at the end like that. So I'll just go in and I'll just hit the selection tool actually and go and just move these around a little bit. Okay, great. So now I've got my anchors in place. What I want to do is add some arrows to make the image move. So I'm going to select single and just simply click and drag. And what you want to do is not make the arrows too big. You kind of want to make them this kind of size, depending on how much motion you want to add. The bigger the arrows, more motion you'll add to your picture. So you just want to kind of draw it out like that. We can keep going, add some more arrows, and then click on the play button. You can see I've got this nice kind of image like this, and what you want to do is just, you know, kind of go in there and maybe add a few more arrows like so. And there we go. We can also adjust the speed of the animation by just simply dragging this out like this. And what I also want to do with this one is I want to add some fog. So I'm going to go over to the effects over here, and I'm just gonna scroll down and add some fog. I'm gonna go grab this one here, kind of zoom out, and then just kind of place it near the bottom like that. And I'm gonna set the speed to slow for this fog, okay? So let's just play this through. And it's looking really nice. So once you're ready and you're happy with your image, what you can do is go to the publish button over here. You can select whether you want it to be an MP4 or a GIF image. I'm going to go with MP4, and let's just set it to two loops and click on publish and give it a name. So let's call this one Waterfall. And you'll be able to see that image will start exporting, and once it's ready we can go view our animated image. So let's just go ahead and preview the video. So let's check this out. And that's how easy it is to go through and create animated images inside of Photo Vibrance. In this video, I'm going to show you how to animate this lion and basically make the hair move inside of Photo Vibrance. So what you want to do with an animal like a lion is you want to kind of mark out first the face. So I'm going to go to the path for the anchors and just simply draw around the face to add like a structure to this image. So I'm just gonna quickly go through and add it around here, like so, and then hit enter. And I also wanna go and add some anchors around the eye so that this also stays in place while the image is moving. So I'm just gonna add around the eyes and also around the nose, like so, and that's looking good. And also probably around the ears, I'm just gonna add some anchors around here and also around here as well. Okay, cool. So now what I can do is go to the arrows, and I'm gonna use the path one over here for the arrows, and just simply draw out a path of where I want this hair to animate. So I'm gonna go with the actual kind of flow of the hair. So just gonna bring it out like this, with the mane, bring this down. Also I'll bring some arrows over here. And also around the face, I'm gonna add some arrows. And yeah, this looking quite good. So what I'm gonna do is just quickly preview that and show you what that looks like. Cool, so as you can see, it's looking really, really nice right now. And it just really helps you to, get more attention to your images. So that's looking really good. I'm also gonna add some over on the ears up here. Add some more motion, maybe around here as well. And maybe a little bit up here. Cool, so that's looking really, really good. And yeah, what I could do now is just simply go through, click on publish, and choose whether I want it to be an MP4 or a GIF, and publish this onto my desktop. So I hope you enjoyed this example of how you can animate hair on animals and really bring your images to life inside of PhotoVibrance. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to animate an iris inside of PhotoVibrance. So what you wanna do is, first of all, just draw out the anchor point, so where you want the image to stay still. So I'm just gonna draw around this iris here. And also I'm gonna draw around the pupil and the inside of the eye, like so. Cool, so what we could do is either draw a path and make it like rotate around, or we could draw some arrows kind of going outside like this, and making it kind of expand and move around like this. So I'm gonna try this one like this, for example. Just add the arrows to draw the motion. Cool, so I'm gonna play this through, see what it looks like. Cool, and as you can see, it really is eye-catching, literally, with this eye. And what you could also do, as I said, if you, for example, let's go and select just the arrows. I'm just gonna select this and remove those arrows. We could go with the path and just draw around this kind of loop, I guess, of motion, and just preview that as well. And that looks super cool, as you can see. So you can really have fun, you know, being creative with certain images like these eyes. And yeah, that's how you can animate an iris inside of PhotoVibrance. In this video, I want to show you how to animate this image to make the dust really kind of fly around with PhotoVibrance. So I'm just going to go to the path for the anchors. I'm just going to draw out around this picture to the places that I want to stay still. So I'm just going to go through and quickly draw around this bike. Okay, cool. So once you've drawn out your path, hit enter on your keyboard and you'll be able to see it locks in all those anchors. And you can go and manually add anchors by clicking on single and just simply pointing and clicking around where you want to add your anchors. Once we've isolated the areas, what we can do now is add in our arrows. And for kind of dust, the best one probably would be to go with the single arrows. If you're drawing out water and things like that, you can use a path and that looks really good. So I'm just gonna go and draw out some arrows over here. And let's just bring them up. And depending on how much motion you want to add, you can draw out your arrows bigger or smaller. Usually it's best to go with not too big ones. But what you want to do is, you know, just draw them out and see what it looks like. A lot of this kind of animating is kind of trial and error, so you kind of have to play around with it, see what looks good to you, and make adjustments. So I'm just going to draw out a few more, like this. Maybe one up here as well. And one there, and let's just preview what that looks like. cool. So that's looking really, really good. I can go through and adjust the speed like that. That's looking really nice. And maybe move this one, make it a little bit smaller. Play around with that. And yeah, let's preview this again. So that's looking really, really cool. So that's how you can create a really nice looking dust effect using the motion arrows inside of Photo Vibrance. And once you're done, simply go to publish. You can then choose whether you want it to be MP4 or a GIF image and how many loops you want. By default, all the animations in here go through in loops. So if you're playing it really fast, it's gonna loop quite quickly and then start again like that. So you wanna kind of play around how much you want it to loop. And yeah, you can just go with one loop if you're gonna be posting on social media because it will automatically loop anyway. Or you can, if you wanna make a longer video, you can just, you know, add two loops, for example, and publish that. Okay, great, so now I've published this video, you have to see, I'll just resize it down. You have to see what it looks like. So it's looking really, really cool. And what you could also do as well, if you wanna have it in different formats, after you've published it, what you can do is adjust the size. Let's say I wanna make it a square one, like that for Instagram, for example. I could just go through and bring this over, done editing, and then I can go through and republish that as another video. So I hope you enjoyed this example of how you can create some really cool looking effects with your images inside of Photo Vibrance.